We're gonna go fishing, fishing. Hi, my name is Donna, and I'm an interpreter with Colorado Parks and Wildlife. I love to fish, and here in Colorado, I can fish year-round. I've caught many species of fish, but you can imagine my surprise when I found out we have Kokanee salmon here in Colorado's waters. So that got me to wondering, where did these fish come from? So now come with me, and we're going to go visit the Mount Shavano Fish Hatchery, where we're going to learn how Colorado Parks and Wildlife manages our aquatic species. Welcome. We're here at the Mount Shavano Fish Hatchery, located in Salida, Colorado. They are currently managing around 7 species of fish, so they have their work cut out for them. So come on and join me as we take a closer look. Fish hatcheries, like Mount Shavano, are places that spawn, hatch, and rear fish to stock the state's lakes and rivers. The 2 main jobs of fish hatcheries are to support opportunities to go angling, or fishing, and to sustain native aquatic species. To learn more about what's hatching here at Mount Shavano, we're going to talk to Brian, the hatchery manager.
Well, the Mount Shavano Fish Hatchery, it's the second largest hatchery in the state of Colorado. It's part of the 19 hatcheries that are run by Colorado Parks and Wildlife. And here at Mount Shavano, we generally raise about 550,000 10-inch trout, which we call a catchable trout. And these are rainbow trout, cutthroat trout, and cutbows, which is a cross between a rainbow and a cutthroat. And then on top of that, we do another 2 to 3 million subcatchables, 2 to 5 inches. And these are trout, Kokanee salmon, and Arctic grayling. Fish hatcheries are important to Colorado, not only for the sport fishery, so to support the anglers that use the resource and make sure that there's fish available for them to catch, but also for the native species in species conservation.
So many anglers, like myself, enjoy catching and eating Kokanee salmon. Can you tell me why you raise the Kokanee salmon and what does that involve?
So Colorado Parks and Wildlife raises Kokanee salmon as a sport fish. And this a lot of the reasons for this is because they're fairly easy to catch and they also taste really good. At Mount Shavano, we get most of our eggs from the Roaring Judy fish hatchery. These salmon, they live in Blue Mesa Reservoir, and just like they would in ocean environment, they run the inlet river. They swim 20 plus miles up that river to the raceways at the Roaring Judy hatchery. And then hatchery technicians and biologists and volunteers, they strip the females of the eggs, they fertilize these eggs, and then these eggs are shipped to Mount Shavano or other hatcheries. And from there, the hatchery techs at one of these hatcheries will feed them, hatch them, feed them, and grow them, and then stock them back into the many lakes that and rivers that receive Kokanee salmon. The cutthroat trout is the only native trout in Colorado, and one of the subspecies is the greenback cutthroat. And this greenback cutthroat is, it's also our state fish of Colorado. And a lot of these places, if we didn't keep up with it, they wouldn't have any cutthroats on the landscape. So in order to keep this going, we brought in some of the fish from the wild into the hatchery. And from there, we spawned these fish and we started a brood stock.
So what is it like to work at a hatchery?
So at a fish hatchery, we have what we call a hatchery technician. And these hatchery technicians are the workers that take care of all the daily needs of all the trout and salmon and eggs on the hatchery. They raise the fish from the time they're a tiny egg up until they're a catchable trout. And part of this involves feeding and cleaning and sorting and moving these fish. They also look for signs of disease or parasites, look at water quality parameters. The other jobs we have available are mainly seasonal jobs or volunteer positions. But one of the best ways to get these positions is actually to contact the hatchery. Also go visit the place, go volunteer. All of the seasonal work, whether you're a temporary or even a volunteer, it really helps if you want to, in the future, become a hatchery technician.
So today I learned Mount Shavano and all of our hatcheries are very important places for both our native species of fish and our sports fish. Without all their hard work, it would make it difficult for us to catch fish and also make it hard for our native species to survive. I hope you enjoyed learning about hatcheries like I did today. If you're interested in learning more, or if you'd like to volunteer or work at a hatchery, please explore the links below.